a must-win situation for Derby. Having lost to Birmingham in the first leg of the weekend, if they have any chance of reaching Wembley in the Championship weekend, they must win here tonight. Eight teams involved in the playoff picture. As you may know, they are the top eight teams from the league season. Derby, at one stage, having looked out of the playoff picture, had a tremendous finish to the season. They grabbed the seventh spot. Birmingham pipped for the title by the Leopards. They finished second. The playoff format is worked out on the team finishing first, playing the team finishing eighth, it's second against seventh, and so on. So that gave us these fixtures: Leopards against the Giants, Bullets against Derby Storm, the Eagles against the London Towers, the Sheffield Sharks against Thames Valley Tigers. Remember, these games played over three legs if necessary. We had some first leg action over the weekend. Let's catch up with that with Suzanne Dando, who's courtside.
Thanks very much, Dominic. Well, you've mentioned that Derby need a win here tonight to stay alive in these playoffs, but it's a must-win situation also for the Sheffield Sharks and the Newcastle Eagles. Well, they play again tonight, and we will, of course, keep you up to date with their second leg game as the evening progresses. But all these teams have fought so desperately hard to make these playoffs. But for five of the league teams, well, their season is over, and all they can do now is sit back, relax, and watch this championship battle unfold. On Saturday, the Thames Valley Tigers caused the first playoff upset against Sheffield. The Sharks dominated the game from the first quarter. With just over 6 minutes to play, Dion Haynes put them up by 13 points. But the Tigers clawed their way back to score 21 of the last 28 points. Thames Valley overcame their Achilles heel at the foul line. They sank 13 out of 16 free throws to beat the Uniball Trophy holders by just 1 point. Chris Finch was not happy.
We didn't execute, we didn't run our offense. We succumbed to their pressure, their physical play. They seemed that they almost started fouling on purpose, and we just weren't strong enough with the ball. And then we lost our heads, myself included, but everywhere along the line.
We've had these ones where we come back at teams, and then we've just cropped the ball easily, and that's something that we're working on now for the playoffs to try and sort out. And I'd say it wasn't a pretty game by all means tonight, but we found a way to win, and we won down.
The Towers' foundations looked solid in their first-round game against Newcastle despite being forced outside in the first quarter. They sank the three-pointers and went 9 points clear at the end of the third. But a Phelps basket 3 minutes from time brought the Eagles to within 2 points of last year's champion. As the clock ticked away, Paul Deffis drained an important three-pointer. Mark Boyd retaliated with a basket, but he missed his two vital free throws. Then with 9 seconds left, Danny Lewis clinched the game for the Towers. Coach Taylor is one step closer to his 11th championship semi-final.
It's something that I've been fortunate enough to make virtually every year that I've been here, and that's the only way you can win the Wimbledon championship is by getting there.
They played hard. We didn't play as well as we can play. When a team shoots as many three-pointers they shot tonight and actually scored them, I think that makes it very difficult. I was glad my guys came back. It looks like we had some momentum, but they're coming back to our place now, and I'm hoping that our fans are going to have the opportunity to see us two more times at the arena.
There was never any doubt who was in control in Saturday's All-Midland playoff clash. The Derby Storm did manage a one-point lead at the end of the first quarter, but Bullets guard Reggie Kirk responded by firing 4 three-pointers at the start of the second. 7 of the 8 Birmingham players on court shot successfully from the arc, and with 1 quarter left to play, the Bullets were ahead by a massive 30 points. They won the tie by 32.
We weren't really tough enough. I don't know if our guys kind of thought, well, it's nice to be here in the playoffs. Nobody thought we'd make it and stuff, but I guarantee you Tuesday we'll come out, and we'll certainly go down fighting if we go down at all.
I've got a lot of confidence in our guys. I know that Derby is not going to roll over, though, and they're a very good basketball game. And it will be a tremendous challenge for our guys to come back after a game like this one and have a solid performance on Tuesday.
So confirmation, the Bullets beating Derby by 32 points. Thames Valley sneaking it against the Sheffield Sharks by just a point. And the Towers beating Newcastle by 5 points on Sunday. Those are second leg ties being played tonight. And there is one first leg tie also taking place. That's Manchester against the Leopards. We'll keep you in touch with all the games being played. Our special guest tonight is Mike Burton, whose Chester team put Birmingham out of the playoffs at this stage last season, Mike. But you watched them in action against Derby at the weekend. How impressed were you by that performance?
It's one of the best performances I've ever seen. Birmingham really came out shooting the ball as well as any team I've seen. They scored 12 three-pointers out of 15.
But it wasn't just that he scored 12. Seven different players contributed to those 12. And when you're going to score 36 points out of 15 shots, you're going to be pretty difficult to stop.
So what does Jeff Jones say to his players about tonight then, having conceded such a heavy loss on the weekend?
Well, his players have finished the season really, really well. In the last 2 months of the regular season, they've beaten the six teams above them in the league. So they know they're capable of doing it, but they just didn't come to play on Saturday. And they've got to go out and they've got to make Birmingham fight for every inch on the floor. They've got to give Birmingham no good looks at the basket.
And they have shown some good strapping qualities, haven't
Absolutely.
They?
Absolutely. They've got a team that can strap. They've got depth. They've got some very, very talented players. They've got some quick players. They've got some height. So he's capable of doing it.
And Mike, very briefly on the other ties being played tonight, the other second leg ties. Towers have to go to Newcastle and try and win it. Thames Valley to Sheffield. Do you see either of them wrapping it up tonight?
I think Thames Valley might. I think Thames Valley are very, very talented, and Sheffield have certainly been going through a difficult patch. But I think it's a tough one for Towers to wrap it up tonight up in Newcastle.
Thanks very much, Mike. It's all about a place in the Championship Finals at Wembley. Let's find out whether it's going to be Birmingham or Derby across to Mike Sharp in the commentary box.
Thank you very much indeed, sir. Let's take a look now at full lineup, starting off with the hometown Birmingham Bullets. It will be Dorsey, Perkins, Sims, Kirk, Lloyd, Clive Allen wears 12, H.L. Coleman wears 13, Chris Haslam wears 14, Adam Casaglia 15, and Fab Flournoy wears number 20. Mike Finger, coach, is going to go with this as his starting lineup. Dorsey wearing 6, Reggie Kirk wearing 9, Nigel Lloyd wears 11, Coleman wears 13, and Haslam wears 14. For the Derby Storm, it will be Baker, Balser, Shaw, Rutledge, Berry, Middleton, Smith, Atwell, Graves, and Windlass. And coach Jeff Jones is going to go with this as his starting lineup. It will be Sedroy Baker wearing 4, Deron Rutledge wears 8, Ted Berry wears 9, Smith wears 11, and Atwell wears 12. And we are set and ready to go here at the NEC. It's game 2, the second leg. The jump's going to be Atwell versus H.L. Coleman. It's up, and Bullets have the first offense. Coach Mike Burton has joined me now at the commentary point. Mike, what sort of a game are we going to get here tonight?
Well, it's going to be a very interesting one. If Birmingham play anything like they did on Saturday, it's going to be really tough for Derby. But they've got to play better defense than that.
The betting, the bookies say Birmingham Bullets to win this one by 12 and take their place in the Championship Finals. Is that after Saturday?
I think it must be, yeah.
Nice move by Deron Rutledge.
It was a tough game Saturday, and I think Derby have got a lot to prove. And Deron is a quality player.
Reggie Kirk down low. Nigel has it up for 3 points.
Well, there's the first one.
Ted Berry has the ball. Smith. Ted Roy comes around, gets it. It's back with Berry. He feeds it down low to Rutledge. Rutledge, nice move again.
Rutledge is very tough inside. If you let him have the ball there, he'll score all night.
Dawson gets it to Reggie Kirk. Reggie goes to work on Ted Berry. It's good.
Reggie.
Baker has it. 8:23 left to play in the first. Ted Berry goes around the screen. Along the baseline has the ball. They go back to Rutledge. Three times down. Great play. Deron Rutledge.
Rutledge is a real class player, and if you let him have the ball in the low post like that every time, they're going to have problems.
Nice no-look pass, and at the other end, and a rejection. I think it may have been Atwell.
Well, yeah.
Got a piece of that. And Baker couldn't keep a hand on the ball. Let's take another look at the rejection at the other end. Haslam was well in there. Great block by Atwell.
He's a good athlete.
Plays at both ends of the court as
he
well.
Does.
Just dumped that one down there.
He's a very exciting English player.
In fact, in the face of all these great Americans that they've got in this team, Atwell was voted by the players, by the fans, their player of the season. Nigel Lloyd has the ball. Will he look for Reggie Kirk long? No, goes short to H.L. Coleman. Back to Nigel. Nigel will put it up for three. Off. Rebound. Ted Berry saves it.
Yeah, good save.
Baker. Ted Roy Baker, former Birmingham Bullets player, up for three. Doesn't get there. Rebound Haslam. Dorsey has the ball for Reggie Kirk. Kicks it long to Nigel Lloyd for his third attempt from the three-point line. In and out. One for three so far, Nigel Lloyd. Oh, great pass.
Ooh.
Missed. Off right. Reggie Kirk. Three on two break. This should end up with Dorsey. Yes, it does. Count the point. Tony Dorsey just loves playing against Derby.
Well, he scores a lot of points, but I think Derby are going to have to be careful with their shot selection. That wasn't a great shot for Sean Smith to take, and he needs to make sure they all count.
Bullet pass by Ted Berry. They get it back to Baker. It's Deron Rutledge from the other side this time. Nice move. Deron doesn't get the point. Rebound Dorsey. Bill Dorsey on the ball. Wraps it around to Nigel Lloyd. Traveled with it.
Well, I Nigel's very happy about that call, Mike.
Ooh, I am surprised. Don't make me laugh, Mike. It only hurts when I laugh.
Some of you people out there might have noticed that Ted Berry's wearing the wrong shirt. He forgot his shirt tonight. So he's wearing Simon Spencer's shirt.
I think somebody got a souvenir between you and me. But
yeah, I think you could be right.
Birmingham lead this by one, 9 points to eight. On the ball, Nigel Lloyd. One of the problems for Derby is that they've got some serious mismatch problems.
Yeah. Well, if they're going to play two small guards, they've got problems. And that highlights it right there, with Reggie Kirk being wide open. And Ted Berry not being able to get anywhere near him.
Deron Rutledge has the ball. Rutledge goes to work on Dorsey. Nice move, Rutledge. Good move.
Rutledge is a class player. If you let him take it inside, he's going to score.
Dorsey has it.
You see Reggie trying to post up Ted Berry down there?
HL calling for it. HL can stick this, and he does. As we mentioned earlier, seven different players scored three-pointers in the game up in the first leg of this. We have other games taking place tonight. We have three games taking place. One is a game one at Manchester, which we'll bring you later. Right now, Newcastle and London are tied 23 apiece. Remember, London Towers have a one-game lead there. Chelsea in the trailing Thames Valley, 16-23. Thames Valley lead that series by one. Substitution is going to bring Brendan Graves into the ballgame for the first time. Derby Storm trail by 17 points to 10.
Yeah, Brendan Graves is a Canadian. The big, strong lad. He's a non-work permit. Because he's got a grandparent in Scotland, apparently.
And a great rebounder and a great shot blocker. And he knocks down a nice turnaround for two. I have to say, I've said it before, I like the look of Graves. There's just something about him around the basket. He hustles well, got bumped there, still got the 2 points.
Does get rebounds. He's a big, strong lad. He does get bored.
Reggie Kirk, oh, nice move, Reggie. Doesn't get the point. Here comes the Storm again. Great hands by Nigel Lloyd. Stolen back by Ted Bates. What a pass! Oh, he said he walked with it.
That seems a harsh call. I'd like to see a replay of that one, Mike. That looks harsh to me. Here we go.
Need to see the feet. That's no
walk. No, I didn't see a walk there. No.
Got that one wrong, ref. There it is. There's the second steal. Unless he said that. Did he say Ted Berry walked with it? I don't know. Reggie has the ball. Moves down the line, fakes, drives, knocks down the two.
Ted Berry's got to play him straight up. He's got to be between him and the basket every time he gets the ball. He can't let him go past him like that.
Okay, 19 points to 12, just a 7-point ball game. Then Roy Baker looking to get to Wembley. They must win here tonight if they're going to get to Wembley. Last time Baker was there, won a championship with the Birmingham Bullets. Can he get there with the Derby Storm? Timeout has been called. 2 minutes 36. Make that 2 minutes 56 left to play in the first quarter. We're going to go down, take a listen to what Coach Jeff Jones. No, make that. Mike Finger is going to say to his time.
Wants you to tighten up the defense a little more. You're not playing with the intensity in the passing defensively that you need to. You're letting them score, guys. You're letting them score. Remember the scouting report. Make Rutledge go to his right. Okay? Over his right shoulder. Make him go left. Alright? And then box out Graves. You gotta put your body on Graves. Make sure you guys are helping us on the rebounds as well. Okay, doing a great job offensively. Keep it up. Keep looking for one another, crashing the boards. But hey, give me a little better effort on the defense.
Well, Coach very unhappy with the defensive intensity, and here are some of the numbers. Derby's been waiting for their first 3 points, and Birmingham are ready with three in the bag and 5-9 from the field. That's his excellent shooting.
Well, absolutely. Birmingham has carried on where they left off on Saturday, shooting 75% from the three-point line.
78% is pretty good stuff from
Yeah,
as well.
It is. You just need to get some more shots, I think.
Early timeout there for Mike Finger. Would you have taken a timeout that early?
Well, I'm not sure to take a timeout if it was five up, but he wanted to get a point across to his team. He doesn't think they're playing tough enough.
Windless into the ball game for the first time. Reggie Kirk. Lloyd has it. HL comes down close up. Dorsey gets the ball. Dorsey, nice move on Smith. Count them two.
Excellent move from Coley. Ball and leg fake to the right. Went left for a little jumper.
In the last regular season game between these two teams, a game that in fact Birmingham lost, Dorsey had a triple-double. Nice crossover. And a steal. HL has it. 3-on-2 break. HL could get it to Dorsey. And he does. Nigel Lloyd at the top, doesn't take the three, gets it to Reggie Kirk. Reggie brings it back outside the arc. Haslam looks to drive. Gets the whistle, it's on Brendan Graves, I think. Chris Haslam was very impressive in the first leg.
Excellent he was. When he got the ball in the low post and he made a move to the basket, there was nobody stopping him. Just then he got it at the high post. And again, Graves let him go past him. But Derby should be able to play a lot better here because he got a bigger lineup, having brought Tony Windlass on for said Roy Baker.
Nigel Lloyd, Joe Brewer has a word with H.L. Coleman. Haslam. Gets one. What do you think has been the difference with this Derby Storm team? Since Christmas, they've been quite impressive.
Well, Jeff Jones has done a great job. He really has got the team playing. And they've got some good players, and they play with a lot of spirit, a lot of fire.
Nice play by Derby right there. Outlet by Barry. Brendan Graves out on the wing. Gets it into Tony Windlass. Knocks it down for the two first points of the night for Tony Windlass. Dorsey has the ball. The matchup now again is Reggie Kirk and Spencer. No, Ted Berry. Reggie has it. Knocks it down for two.
If Ted can't get anywhere near him, he's just not big enough to defend him.
What would you do? Would you change the defensive personnel?
I think I just want to play him a lot closer. I'd want to get all over him and make him go past me. Make him take it to the basket. He's going to get help then. But he can't stand off him and let him take those shots.
Brendan Graves has it. Rutledge loses it. Gets it back. Good save by Windlass. Shot clock is at 7. Now Smith drives. Gets it to Windlass. Great play.
Great pass. Great pass from Sean Smith.
Here it is again. Sean Smith finds Windlass down low. Windlass reverses it for two. 6-point ball game. Haslam is rejected.
Great check. I'd like to see that again. It looks a great check from here.
They say Rutledge committed the offense. Let's take another look.
I think it's...
Clean block.
Pretty clean from here.
Haslam back on the line for two. First one is good. Doesn't get there. Graves hustles, keeps possession.
Yeah, the Birmingham team aren't very happy about that. I think they thought it came off Brendan Graves.
Ted Berry has the ball. Berry looks around, sees there 15 seconds left on the clock, and they will hold for the final shot of the quarter. Berry has it. Berry, nice, he splits the defense, puts it up and knocks down the two.
Might be a bit early.
Left. That's too long. Yeah. We go down to the other end. The shot clock should not have moved. Oh, well, we got that all kind of wrong.
No, well, once the referees aren't going to blow the whistle.
Yeah, there was no timeout for
it. Right, no.
It's a six-point ball game. It's game two of this three-game series. The Bullets lead the series by one, and they lead this ball game by six.
The original entertainer simply has to give his best to become world champion again. Carl Thompson holds the WBO Cruiserweight World title, and he's more than ready to defend it. Saturday at 9, Sky Box Office 3, Double Trouble.
To book, call 0990-800-800, order early and receive a £5 discount. Check that you can receive this 1B channel before ordering. Cable customers, contact your local operator.
When I tell people I'm part of the World Lamb Speed Crew, they get pretty excited. They ask, like, are you the driver? Are you the designer? Are you the owner? Nope, I'm the safety guy. I pick up the parachute after the run. They look a little disappointed and go, oh, that's pretty, great. And I say, nope, not the drive home is.
Another big night of boxing coming up on Sky Box Office. Prince Nassim Hamed defends his WBO featherweight title against Alfredo Vasquez. Chris Eubank steps up to cruiserweight to challenge Carl Thompson for a world title. And Herbie Hyde steps into the ring to defend his WBO heavyweight title against Damon Reed. For further information on this special Sky Box Office event, call 0990-800-888. That's 0990-800-888 for more information on a great night of world championship boxing. It's playoff action here at the NEC for us. Birmingham against Derby. Let's get back to Mike Sharp and Mike Burns.
And let's take a look at some of the numbers on that first quarter. Birmingham should be very happy with this. 3-for-4, 75% of their three-pointers, 75% of their free shots, and 64% from the field. Doesn't get much better than that, does it?
No, it's pretty good stuff. They'll be very pleased with that. One of the big factors is that Derby haven't been to the foul line at all.
10 for 13 from the field, Derby, and that's where all their points have come. 6-point ball game, 26 to 20. Graves and H.L. Coleman, Reggie Kirk has the ball. Nigel Lloyd. Now Reggie Kirk has got Tony Windlass defending him. Nigel Lloyd looking to post up Ted Berry. In and out, rebound Haslam. Haslam with a spin move, runs into a brick wall and doesn't get there. Brendan Graves pulls down the board. Rutledge calling for the ball. Windlass has it, puts it up for three. No good. Rebound, who's got the ball? Nigel Lloyd. 2-on-1.
Oh, great pass from Tony Dawson.
It's good.
Great pass from Tony Dawson. Here it comes. Bounce pass. Powerful pass. Straight up into his chest. He can make a great pass from there.
Windlass gets it to Ted Berry. Berry. Windlass has it back in the middle. Oh, boy. I think we'll get 2 points here. Eventually.
Well, it wasn't pretty, but they all count.
We have some latest scores coming in. We have the first from Manchester. Manchester 27, Greater London Leopards 32. That is a game one, remember, of their three-game series. two game twos taking place elsewhere tonight. They are Newcastle 39, London Power 35. Remember, London lead that series 1-0. And Sheffield Sharks 34, Thames Valley Tigers 49. Sheffield need to get going if they're going to stay in this playoff. Dorsey on the post. He's coming baseline. Yes, he is. Doesn't get the point. Rebound, Reggie Kirk. Will get the drop. They say passing is good. Foul is called, I think, on Tony Windlass. Reggie will go to the line. Reggie Kirk already has 13 points.
He's a tough player, Reggie. Doing a heck of a job. But, you know, Derby are playing a lot better tonight, Mike. They're playing with a lot more spirit, a lot more fire. They're putting Birmingham under a lot more pressure.
First foul on Tony Windlass into the ball game for the first time for the Bullets. Clive Allen, and for Derby, Bryan Balser into the ball game for the first time. Reggie puts it up, doesn't get there. Rebound, Brendan Graves, and here comes the Derby Storm. With a two-man ball with Balser and Berry.
He wants him to run across the baseline and Birmingham in his zone. Looking to run the shooter across the baseline. Both is a heck of a good shot.
Oh, that's what a whoa, that is a gorgeous play. Great, great offense. That's the way to beat the zone defense.
Absolutely.
Nigel Lloyd has it. Nigel right down the middle. Oh, that double pump. Doesn't get there, rebound. Clive Allen breaks out with it, gets it back to Nigel. In the paint. Clive Allen, now Dorsey for three. Doesn't get there, rebound ball to Ted Berry has it. Derby Storm off and running, nice change of pace. Oh, what a play by Ted Berry.
Woo!
Gets the whistle as well.
He's got some great hand time as Ted.
Goes up there and saves it, look at this. I love the way the running layer. Birmingham led this one by nine, no more than a couple of minutes ago. If they make this one, it's down to a one-point ball game. Ted Berry on the line. We got us a one-point ball game, 29 to 30. Woo! Remember, this is game two. Unfortunately, we have a problem. Spencer is looking for his shirt at the moment. Reggie Kirk doesn't get there. That's the Birmingham ball. Ted Berry lost his shirt, had to borrow one. He's wearing number nine, but it says Spencer on it. But we know Ted Berry when we see it.
I think after the game on Saturday, the odds were so good on Birmingham that he put his so good on Derby that he put his shirt on him.
He lost it. There he is. It's actually Ted Berry. We do apologize about the shirt situation, but I was here. We know. On the ball in the ball game for the first time, Fab Flournoy. What an effect Fab had when he came onto the court on Saturday.
Well, he's a very explosive player, Mike. I mean, you don't have to see him score threes, but he can jump and he can take it to the basket well.
Dorsey gets the offensive board. Do up a bit of a prayer, it has to be said. Balser. Berry has it. Graves calling for it. Oh, Ted Berry gives it up. 2-on-1 break as well. Leaves it. It's oh, baby! Tony Dorsey on the assist by Nigel Lloyd. Pulls it out to a 3-point ball game.
Those two have got such a great understanding. They just know each other so well. They've been playing together for so long. Just automatic.
Dorsey just goes up there and throws it down. Balser has the ball. Five turnovers by the Storm, make that six turnovers by the Storm. Dorsey doesn't get the bucket. I think going to say to the line.
I think this would be a good time for a timeout, you know, for Derby. They haven't had one yet. And they've lost it the last two times down the floor.
Ted Berry commits the foul. Ted goes to the bench, Ted Roy Baker into the ball game for the first time. Dorsey puts it up, is good for the first one. Tony Dorsey shooting about 73% from the line. Suddenly it's a 5-point ball game. Now Senroy Baker will control the ball. As well, ball for pops out. Brendan Graves posting up, gets the ball, goes to work across the paint, doesn't get the bucket, gets the whistle on Clive Allen. That's the first foul on Clive. There it is again.
Yeah. Well, if he's going to stand behind him like that, he's going to have problems. Clive's better off trying to stop him getting the ball, but once his arm's sticking out like that, this contact is a foul automatically.
Bridge going to the line for two. First one is good. That score from the first leg must be haunting Jeff Jones of what? 111 to 79.
Yeah, well, that sort of score can drive you as well, and it can drive your team. They don't want to finish on that sort of scoreline. They're pressing now. They've really got their tails up. They're really into it. They want to take this to a third game.
Reggie Kirk gets it down low to Fab. Fab across the paint. Doesn't get there. Great tip, I think it may have been. Is it Fab or Dawson? Not quite sure. Dorsey has it. Dorsey, turnaround jumper, doesn't get there. Clive Allen with the offensive board will go to the line for two. You know, Birmingham, they've lost games to Derby.
Oh, yes.
In the regular season.
Absolutely. Derby have beaten them at Moorways, and they've beaten them on Sky TV. Derby know how to beat them. There's no doubt about that. And they've got enough talent to do it.
Tough play by Clive Allen, getting the board and going straight back up with it.
Now, if Clive scores the next one, he's coming out. They've got a provisional substitution. They've got Chris Haslam coming in for him, but he's got to put this in the basket.
He doesn't. Well, they get the offensive board through Fab Flournoy. Now the Bullets will reset. Down low, Dorsey, what a move.
Well, you just can't let him have the ball there. You're letting him have the ball 10, 12 feet from the basket. And Tony Deadly from there. They've got to deny him. They've got to stop the ball coming in.
Ben Berry. Berry gets the high screen from Atwell. Fedroy Baker. Sean Smith goes left. Sean Smith, nice spin move. And one. Great play by Smith. I'm not sure. Well, you know, we talked about this. Who initiates the contact?
Yeah, right. Well, Mike Finger's not very happy at all. He thinks it was a charge. He thinks Sean Smith dribbled in. But let's watch it. Nice spin there. And Fab jumps across him. Fab gets there late. It's a good call. It's a good call.
Reggie Kirk goes out. Clive Allen goes out. H.L. Coleman and Chris Haslam back into the ball game. Sean Smith on the line for one. This could cut it to a 2-point ball game. He doesn't do it. Here come the Bullets again.
Oh, dear. Fab wide open. Wide open, but he doesn't want to take it.
He made one of those.
He did, but he doesn't make them very often.
To be fair, he doesn't take them very often.
No.
That's the walk. We got the two small guards back on the floor together for Derby.
Yeah, well, that's really very difficult for the matchup.
Ted Berry gets there. Berry turns up, faces the basket. Puts it up for three. Off. Always. And that's going to be a Bullets ball. De'Ron Rutledge also back into the ball game. You know, De'Ron came in and had a great start to the season, then suffered a broken leg, took him out for 10 games, but has been doing a good job since he came back.
He's a class player. He's a real quality player. If you let him get the ball within 12 feet of the basket, most of the time he's going to score. You've got to stop him getting the ball.
But he's blown right down low to HL for three. Doesn't get there. Rebound De'Ron.
That's a great rebound from De'Ron. He's not 100% fit, but when he's pulling down rebounds like that, you wonder what he's like when he is.
Smith has it. Smith. Little crossover through the leg. Comes back to the top. Gets it back. De'Ron Rutledge comes and doesn't set the screen. Smith's going to go one-on-one. Fade away. And one. Is that?
It is.
Yes, it is.
It is.
Woo. What a play by Sean Smith.
He's a class player, Sean.
4 for 5 from the field. Timeout has been called by Coach Mike Finger. Wants to talk this over. 36 points to 35. We are going to go down, take a lesson to what Mike Finger is going to say to his guys. In fact, he's going to go over and talk to the official before he talks to his guys. Let's go have a quick listen to Jeff Jones, first of all, then.
Listen up, we're in 12, back to 5. You two are interchangeable. You're interchangeable. In other words, if Haslam or Coleman are back and you're first, just take whoever's back. The other one go back. You still... No. Yeah. He's got Flournoy. And you two are interchangeable with Flournoy and Nigel. All right? You're not. You're fine, Dorsey, right away. All right. Offensively, we have two mismatches. Dorsey doesn't want to foul out. We got Duran inside, or we got Sean outside with Haslam. He's bringing it up.
There he is, the Derby Storm bench. The points per quarter so far, 26 to 20, of course, at the end of the first. And here we are, Derby leading this one by 15 to 10. You know, if Derby want to take a look at the record book, some years ago, Thames Valley Tigers finished top of the league, played Derby, who finished eighth. You know who went to the championship?
You know who won at the championship? Derby did a heck of a job. They actually made the final that year. I think Jason Seaman was playing that year for Derby, wasn't he?
Yeah. Let's take a look at the floor shooting as well while we're at it. 14 for 30, 47% for Birmingham, 67% for Derby. And this is what's keeping Derby in the game, because
absolutely,
they're not making the three.
No, but they're not taking as many shots as Birmingham. Yeah, but...
Sean Smith will go to the line. Derby had a nightmare shooting on Saturday, 31%. 39 make that. While the Bullets were 61%. So Derby has definitely come prepared for this one.
Well, they're playing a lot tougher. They're in the faces of Birmingham, making it tough. Plus, they're going to the boards and contesting every rebound.
Reggie Curtis back on the floor. We're expecting some three-point magic now from the Bullets. You remember, it was the second quarter on Saturday night where Reggie set 4 threes in a row.
Yeah, but he was wide open. He's not going to get wide open tonight. Derby are playing man-to-man. They played a zone in the second quarter on Saturday. I think they've learned from that.
Nice spin move by Dawson.
Oh.
They say Smith took him across the arm. Oh, Sean says, that was close. I nearly got you that time. It's those same rows, you know. Let's have a look. You know, it's that, you know, Billy told me about this. Billy says, you know, even if it's close sometimes, when you bring it down with so much energy, they're going to give the call to the offensive player.
Well, they are, but the key is not to let him go past you. Play him straight up.
This is down low, stolen away. Ted Berry has the ball. Berry looks to drive. Berry goes a long way around. Unfortunately, has to step out.
Steps out of corner.
Now Nigel Lloyd to advance the ball. 3 minutes left to play in the half.
You know, Mike, Derby had two chances to tie this game up at the foul line and haven't been able to get it done.
Reggie, nice first move. Dorsey for three. It's good. They can make those 3 pointers in so many different places.
Well, with so many different players as well. That's the strength of them.
Ratliff drives. Yeah, whistle on Dorsey.
Pulls the foul off Tony, yeah.
You know, something I like going back to Saturday's game, which was, you know, told me a lot about these two teams. The matchup of Rutledge and Dorsey was gorgeous in the first
game. It was excellent, yeah. Yeah, they're both athletes, they're both very, very good offensive players.
Rutledge on the line for two. Trying to cut this to a two-point ball game. Duran misses the first. The second. So now it's a three-point ball game, 39 to 36. Dorsey has the ball. Broke that press with no problem. Nigel for three. It's short. Rebound, Nigel Lloyd. Dorsey ends up with the ball, and now it's Smith. And they have the numbers. Ted Berry. Oh! Nice move by Brendan Gray.
Great pick.
Pretty layup by Berry. Wasn't going to get the point. Brendan Gray. Gets it. And Dorsey will go to the line for two.
pretty explosive fell a play there.
Yeah, it's up and down still.
Here it is again.
Yeah, he hit it with the body.
Dorsey going to the line for two. Windlass back into the ball game. Sean Smith goes out. Dorsey is doing all the scoring at the moment for the Bullets.
Well, he's one of the big contenders for the MVP of the season, isn't he?
Yeah. I think he might be down to two now, but I'm guessing, as you know.
I think you might be right.
2 minutes, 8 seconds left to play. Dorsey has 15 personal. 4-for-4 from the line tonight. I think he could be heading for another triple-double here tonight. Ted Berry has it. Berry off the glass, doesn't get there. Nigel Lloyd, 3-on-2 break. HL calls through it, gets it, and then gives it up. And then Chris Haslam, Nigel. Gets it down low to Haslam. Haslam goes to work, then kicks it back out. Good two-man ball. Boy, that was an offensive foul if I ever saw one.
Well, I think it was a bit of a flop as well, though.
Ted Berry to Windlass. Windlass looking inside, gets it to Graves. Is fouled by Reggie Kirk.
He's just playing it to me. That's all I want to know.
Mike Finger says it's playing to me. So the referee says it wasn't a foul up there, it was one down here.
Getting a bit excited, yeah.
I think that was a foul, don't you?
That was definitely a foul.
Graves misses the first. Boy, that free throw shooting is going to start hurting.
It's going to hurt us. Yeah, it's not good.
Shooting at 50%. Going down. 4-for-9 from the free throw line. H.L. Coleman, they say a three for that.
You can't give any of them good luck. You just can't do it.
Darby Storm definitely struggling from that free throw line. Made just four. Windlass has the ball. Now. Windlass. Ted Roy Baker kind of bobbled it. Don't know whether that made him miss, but missed he did. Nigel Lloyd gets it to Haslam. Now H.L. Coleman. Haslam too high off the glass. Rebound Rutledge. What a pass. Great delay by Brendan Gray. Technical foul called on Mike Finger. That was coming. That will be two shots and possession to the Derby Storm. 36 seconds left in the quarter. There's no doubt that Mike hasn't liked the last couple of calls. Said something to Richard Stokes, and Richard Stokes had heard enough to tee him up straight away.
Well, he's not been comfortable from the start, really. He called a timeout. He called a timeout when his team were 5-up and had to go on his team about defense. I think he's feeling the pressure. I mean, it's understandable. There's a lot of pressure out there. And I think it's coming out in his coaching. But I'm sure he's an excellent coach. He's got some great players. He's going to get the job done. But it might go to three games. You never know.
Ted Roy Baker makes the two. Cuts this to a two-point ball game. 36 seconds left. 36 seconds left to play in the half. I can tell you that should this go to three games, we will be back here. It will be back here on Sunday for game three. Now, Derby Storm looking to run the clock down, holding for the last offense of this first half. Ted Roy Baker has the ball. A two will tie, a three will give him a one-point lead going into the half. Ted Berry drives, lays it up for two. We are tied to 7 seconds, 8.5 seconds in fact, left to play. And now Dorsey has the ball, knocked away, Dorsey gets it back, and it's blocked. There it is, the end, buzzer has gone.
It won't count.
That will not count. The buzzer has gone, and we are at the end of the half. There's Mike Finger, still having something to say to Richard Stokes. It is halftime in this one. Of the three-game series. The Bullets lead the series by one, but we are tied in game two. It's 44 apiece.
Well,
if you wanted excitement, and you've come to the right place, haven't you? A tremendous finish to that first half. After the break, we'll have a great competition for you. Get your pens and paper at the ready and join us after the break.
Merton, Townsend, and of course, Gascoigne. A Premiership lineup with Premiership ambition. They now await Joe Royal's Man City, their ambition to avoid the drop. A game neither can afford to lose. Middlesbrough v Man City, part of a great weekend of football on Sky Sports.
Of April, pump adjustable seats completed.
Fan-shaped water jets which reduce water consumption, and therefore the water bottles can be smaller, which helps to reduce the weight of the car.
Take Hans for a walk, Harry. You could do with the exercise.
Oh, come on, Hans.
Here. Hey, good outlet.
Oh.
Hey, I've done you the power of good.
With a crisp wafer and a light flake center, Time Out helps you make the most of your break.
Right. Let's do it.
Make the break with Cadbury's Time Out.
Regular season, the New York Knicks still looking for a playoff spot. They come up against Washington this Friday on Sky Sports 3 from 4 p.m. Here at the NEC, we're watching playoff action, and it's Birmingham against Derby. It is all square at 44 points apiece at the halfway stage, and Mike Burton, Birmingham letting it slip really towards the end of that second quarter.
Well, I think Derby played with a lot of fire. They really came out and played tough basketball, and they kept themselves in the game.
On Saturday, you watched Derby trying to play a zone against Birmingham and failing. We've seen tonight Birmingham adopting the zone against Derby.
Yeah, well, I don't think Derby has got as many shooters as Birmingham, so I think that the Birmingham zone will help them. But Derby did do a very good job against Birmingham here. They ran Balser across the baseline, got him open there, but he hit Graves inside. He found Atwell going down the middle for a wide-open basket.
And Birmingham was certainly making the three for most of that night.
Yeah, Birmingham are sticking the 3 points, but they get no looks to do that. But Derby are fighting and they keep themselves in the game, and this could go to Derby. This could go to three games.
One of the crucial factors probably in the second half will be the Nigel Lloyd and Tony Dorsey, the veterans of this side, and it'll be important whether they can pull it off, won't
they? Well, they've got a great understanding between each other. So you see, they get a steal here. Nigel gets the ball, he knows Tony's right behind him. He's going down the floor to 2-on-1, he draws the defender. Bounce back behind him for a Dawson stuff. I mean, that's pretty impressive basketball.
You pointed out a couple of times that perhaps the Derby defence wasn't quite as tight as it could have been in that.
Yeah, it needs to be aggressive. It needs to play hard for the next 20 minutes. Those times when they got wide open shots, Birmingham, and you can't give them those shots. They're not knocking them down like they were on Saturday, though. But I expect Derby to come out fired up. They've seen some light at the end of the tunnel, and they're going to come out and really fight for every inch on the floor now.
Well, let's see what the numbers say then. From this first half, Mike. And well, in terms of three-point shooting, it's very decisive, certainly. Although Derby in two-point terms are doing very well.
Yeah, well, Derby are doing a good job at two-point range. I mean, 76% is excellent. They're not doing so well in three-point land, but they weren't at the foul line at all in the first quarter. They've got themselves there now and starting to get some points and slip away and pull themselves back in the game. They're not taking as many shots as Birmingham, though. They need to try and tie it up on the board so they get more shots, so they get more rebounds.
Well, let's have a look at the situation on the board. And it certainly favours Birmingham in terms of offensive rebounds, and they've been taking some points from that as well.
Well, yeah, you can see though, Birmingham have 21 rebounds to Derby's 16, and turnovers are pretty even.
What about
What about the bench, sorry?
Yeah, well, because Derby have got a good, strong bench, and they're bringing players in, and they're able to contribute. Birmingham have never had the strong bench. They've gone with their main five players. But they don't get into foul trouble, so it doesn't really affect them that badly.
OK, and the leadometer. Well, Birmingham dominant throughout most of that half, but the fact is, Mike, that we are level at half-time.
We've got 20 minutes to go, yeah, for another push at game three.
OK, it's looking interesting for the second half. Let's go courtside to Van Dander.
Thanks very much, Dominic. Well, we know anything can happen in this game of basketball, and I'm sure the Bullets fans weren't expecting to see their team going into the break. Equal points and being pushed all the way by the Derby Storm. But for some of the optimistic fans out there, I'm sure some of them will already book their tickets for Wembley. But we're giving you the chance to win some tickets to go to the Wembley Championship weekend on the 2nd and 3rd of May. So listen up and have your pens and papers handy. The fight for the championship trophy is fierce. Every team has fought hard to qualify for a playoff position. This is the final assault for trophy glory. The winning and the losing can bring with it every emotion. For the chance to win a VIP weekend for a family of four to the Budweiser Wembley Championship, all you have to do is answer the following question. London Towers won last year's championship title under the most successful basketball coach in the country, Kevin Cadle. How many times has Kevin Cadle, as coach, won the championship? Is it four times, five times, or six times? Please send your entries to the following address. Sky Competition, British Basketball League, PO Box 5492, Birmingham, B36. 9LN, and entries must be in by Friday the 24th of April.
Well, good luck to you if you're going to have a go at that. It is a tremendous weekend, and of course it's on Sky Sports Saturday and Sunday the 2nd and 3rd of May. Right here we're watching the playoff game between Birmingham Derby. It's all tied up. We'll be back with the second half right after this break.
I'm the king of the featherweight.
Wilfredo Vasquez has been waiting a long time to dethrone the king. Prince Nassim still has something to prove. Just who is the best featherweight in the world? Saturday at 9, Sky Box Office 3, Double Trouble.
To book, call 0990-800-800, order early and receive a £5 discount. Check that you can receive this 1B channel before ordering. Cable customers, contact your local operator. Ever. 38 great dance beats and old school classics. The best rap tracks of all time. The best hip-hop anthems ever.
You know, we're still the land of meals on wheels. And in Lancashire, you can still get a great hot pot. Or go to Edinburgh and see the tattoo. And of course, the British male is still not considered as amorous as his Latin counterpart. It's good to know things haven't changed a bit.
Live football coming up this week as both the Nationwide League and the Premiership reach their climax, or come towards it anyway, on Friday night from 7 o'clock on Sky Sports 2. It's Middlesbrough against Manchester City, then on Sunday from 3 on Sky Sports 1, Coventry against Liverpool. That's our live football coming up this week on Sky Sports. Right now, of course, it's playoff action here at the NEC, Birmingham against Derby. Let's get back to Mike Burton and Mike Sharp.
Yeah, thanks very much indeed. And Sean Smith in your picture now. Started the ball game, had a great first half, it has to be said. Then the coach took him out. We weren't quite sure why he took him out. Let's take a look at this, something that was going on the bench as they went into the half-time break. He's been bandaged.
and looks as if he's injured. Now, the situation is this. He was 4 for 5 from the field, 80%, and looking very, very good.
Yeah, well, he looks like he's got an ankle turn. But he's capped it all up, and it looks like he's going to go with it.
The situation, you don't want to say this about guys, but, you know, you got to lay it on the line here, because there's no tomorrow.
You just don't That's right. Well, he's going out there. There he goes. He's a tough player. He's 2 years out of college. He played in Iceland last year.
Iceland?
He played in Iceland last year. So he's probably got a good ankle. He's probably got a lot of grimace on it. Yeah.
There's a little grimace on that face. Got eight fine-looking points, moved across the paint very nice indeed on a couple of plays. Okay, we are tied at 44. This is game two. The Bullets lead the series by one. Dorsey has the ball to Nigel Lloyd. Lloyd drives with a spin move and then waits and now puts it up and knocks it down.
Well, he was double teamed for a brief period and then the big man went away and he just shoots over the top of Stenroy.
Two more for Nigel Lloyd and now Ted Berry has it to Smith. Now Baker gets it to Berry down the middle. Great play, great offense by the Derby Storm. Tied again, this time at 46. Dorsey on the ball. Dorsey killer crossover and rejected by Maxwell. Ted Berry has it. Berry, nice little shake and bake. Kicks it out to Stenroy Baker for three.
Excellent play from Ted Berry there. Penetrates to the whole floor.
The first lead for the Derby Storm comes on a big three-pointer by the former Bullets player, Stenroy Baker. Stenroy, of course, was the one who stuck the three and won that regular season game. And Baker back on the ball, gets it to Ted Berry. Smith trying. Oh, what a move! Ted Berry doesn't get the bucket, but Tyrone Rutledge does!
Some great work from Atwell there. Got the rebound, found the open man. Well, he's had one sec already. He's got to be very careful. He doesn't get a second to get thrown out of the gym.
We have latest scores coming in. We'll get those to you as soon as there's a break in play. Let you Kirk have the ball. Shot clock is down to 10. Dorsey working on Smith. Blocking foul is the call on Atwell. Okay, let's take a look at some of those latest scores. Newcastle Eagles 59, London Towers 42. London Towers only scoring 7 points in the third quarter.
Well, that's usually what they do to other teams, you know, Mike.
Yeah, now the situation there is that Towers lead the series by one. They won their home leg. So this looks like it's going to go to three games. And the third game will be at Newcastle on Sunday. Whereas at Sheffield, Thames Valley Tigers, who won the first leg on their score, are leading by 13 points. And they could be back at Wembley for the first time in 5 years. Boy, woo, it's getting interesting.
It certainly is.
I wonder what the Sheffield fans are thinking up there, man. That's a serious whoop that's going on up there. Mm.
Hey, it's early days though, 13 points, you got John Amici in there?
Yeah, Mark Robinson, all the guys are there, but can they come with something? Windlass has it. Windlass gets it down low to Gray. Gray, nice move, doesn't get the drop, rebound Chris Haslam. And here comes Nigel Lloyd. Reggie Kirk gets out and gets it to Dorsey. Back to Nigel for three. Doesn't get there, rebound Dorsey. And a steal by Stenroy Baker. Three on two. Baker slows it down, gets it to Ted Berry, gets it back. And now Jerron Rutledge. There's a run, take it down the lane. Gets a little screen. Brendan Gray for two. It's good. Derby Storm stepped up here. There's Sean Smith getting more running repairs. Lots of ice on that ankle. Leading right there, coach. Does look like the ankle.
Yeah, but, I mean, Derby have got good strength in depth.
And there's Lloyd on the ball. Reggie Kirk has it. Reggie comes right. Now he goes left with a spin move. Reggie in the paint. Drop clock is down to six. They get it to HL. That looked like a walk.
It was. Yeah.
HL just trying to do a little killer crossover. Some body swerve. Actually walked with it.
Sean Smith, you know, they could do with getting him back into this ball game. They do a good job here. A very good job. On the ball. Brendan Gray, the fadeaway, no good. Rebound, H.L. Goldman. Dolphy has the ball. That pass them to the right. That Ricky Kirk to the left. Oh, tough play. Doesn't get the point. Rebound, H.L. gets the whistle.
You know, Derby are getting bodies in there defensively, but they've got to come up with a rebound. They've got to turn that defensive presence into rebounds. They've got to go up and get the board.
I think that's on Teroy Bacon, going quite clearly there. You know, talking about championships, I mentioned before, Teroy Bacon won the Wembley Championships with the Birmingham Bullets. He was captain of the team that time. Tony Windlass, who's on the other side, won it with the London Towers last year, and he's looking to get back there this year. We have another latest score for you. This is a game one. Remember, this is the first leg. Manchester 45, Greater London 59. Misses them both. And here's Nick Nurse in the house at the NEC. Just flew in from the USA today. He actually took the bullet to the championship and won it with Dorsey and Lloyd and who else was in there? Trevor Gordon, of course, by General. This is Windlass. And what a move. Doesn't get the point. And Windlass on that night on the losing side with the London Towers. HL for three. Doesn't get there. Rebound. Whoa.
Ooh.
Boy, that was a close line if I ever saw one.
Yeah, but I think they let the defense, the team with the ball, play on. Advantage, disadvantage rule.
Coach Jeff Jones calling for motion from his side. Teroy Baker gets it back to Ted Perry. 47-53. Down low, Jerome Rutledge. Rutledge, nice move.
Oh, he's foul on the coach.
Going to the line to two, Jerome Rutledge. There's Smith trying to run off that injury. He knows he has got to get back out there. They're going to need him in this ball game. Remember, if it goes in overtime, we just keep playing. We have to have a result here tonight.
Got to get a result, yep.
Jerome Rutledge gets the first. Has 14 points in this one. 47-54, biggest lead, I think, for Derby. Jerome Rutledge gets them both. And it's now an 8-point ball game. Dorsey on the ball, a little full-court pressure. Dorsey gets it over the halfway line. Looks up to Jerome Rutledge. Reggie Kirk, front.
Ooh. I'm not sure about that one either, Mike.
I think they're going to put that one on, let's see.
They're going to go Tony Windlass, I think, don't they?
It's either 13 or 14. I think that means giving it to Gray.
Ooh, well. Well, I didn't see it, you know. Leave it at that.
Nice smile from Brendan Gray. Leading the league in shot blocking at the moment really is impressive at the defensive end of the court. Boy, this missing free throws is catching, contagious. Bullets have only 3 points in this quarter. Make that four. And they've played over 4.5 minutes. Now, Teroy Baker advancing. Baker, a lot of movement on offense. Windlass has it. Gets it down low. Windlass, nice first move. Is no good, offensive board. And Graves will go to the line, I think. Provided they don't say he was on the floor. Jeff Jones, very happy with this.
Yeah,
so Jeff. He realized that it wasn't happening on Saturday very, very quickly, didn't he?
Oh, yeah, there's nothing he could do. He tried to change everything, and they just couldn't stop Birmingham. It's one of those days. But the players have come to play today. And this guy's getting a lot of rebounds. He's getting fouled, but he's not putting the ball in the basket. He's got to put the free throws in.
Brendan Gray. 2-for-4 from the free throw line. Misses again. Ted Berry, but picked up. Free throw shooting is
exactly the same for both teams. 53%, it should be up 75-80%. Hard off the glass, Dorsey doesn't get there. Boy, still doesn't get there. Look like Dorsey can be tossed around the rim, I have to say. Ted Berry has it. Ted Berry with a set of steps. No look pass. Foul is on Angel Coleman.
That was a great pass from Ted Berry to Tony Windlass.
Great offense. Great offense.
You know, Tony's going to go to the foul line here. You know, on Saturday in the game, Derby Storm shot 68% from the foul line, and Birmingham shot 88%, 21 of 24. Neither team are doing that. I think it must be the nerves.
Well, for one team, they make this one. They are in the championship, the final four. And for the other team, if they should win this one and get the drop, then we're back for game three. Windlass gets them both.
That's a 9-point lead now for Derby.
Biggest lead of the ball game, and he's tied up. Ooh, nearly a 5-second call there. Richard Church has it. Back to Fab and Nigel for three. Doesn't get there. Rebound, Haslam. And now Richard Church looks up and sees Windlass. Aitel looks to drive and does. Then to the fadeaway. Aitel doesn't get there. Nice tip. Windlass has it.
Three on one.
Ted Berry has it taken away by Reggie Kirk. Now it's down to Brendan Graves. Denny to miss the foul.
Unheld.
Fab was about to throw that one down. Birmingham Bullets 10 without a score. 10 shots. Last 10 times down without a score. Boy, woo! They have only 4 points in this quarter. Yes, Fab looked as if he was going to jam this down.
Well, I don't think Brendan was going to have it jammed on him.
I think that was a foul. I don't think anybody could argue about anything there. Brendan Graves, that's his third foul. You know, Jeff needs to take now. Can he leave him out there? In fact, he's taking him out. I think that's a good decision by
I think it's a good move, but it's a tough one when he hasn't got Sean Smith either.
Smith is probably a better offensive player, but Graves is definitely a better defensive player.
Yeah, I agree with that, Mike.
Gets them both past Flournoy from the line. There's Smith still getting help down there on the bench. If he doesn't finish this one, I mean, you know about injury, so do you think he could be back there for a game three?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. They'll do a lot of work on him. That'll physio work out, but he still might go in, you never know.
I think if it gets tight, he knows he's got to be ready to come in. Ted Berry with a running layup, it's no good. Fab Flournoy with the rebound. It's a 3-on-2 break. Fab wraps it around to Nigel Lloyd. Lloyd gets it back down low to Fab.
I think the ref could have called a 3-second call there, you know, on Reggie Kirk.
That was one early call on the foul. So Ron Rutledge picks up number three. Substitution is going to bring Balser into the ball game. Baker goes out. Foul to get into Munster now for the Derby Storm. There's Ted Roy Baker. And there's his replacement on court, Bryan Balser. Bad misses the first.
Yeah, you know, Derby has had a good lead, had a 9-point lead, they've got a 7-point lead now. They need to really get good offenses when they go down. They really make sure that they're going to score when they go down. And then play hard defense at the other end. They don't want to rush anything.
Ted Berry has only 7 points, needs to get going, doesn't he?
It certainly does. Birmingham will come up with a half-court trap defense now. Back to a 2-3 zone. Then a 1-2-2 half-court trap. Back to a 2-3 zone. It'll be interesting to see what Derby do. They're running the same players they ran in the first half. They've run Balser across the baseline.
Jerome Rutledge!
That's good.
And knocks down the two from the top of the key.
Well, they had good ball movement and good personnel movement there to get a wide open shot.
Nigel Lloyd gets it to Reggie Kirk. And Haslam posting up, and Haslam comes at the screen. They wrap it around, and Nigel has it back by Flournoy, calling for it on the post. Gets it and goes to work. Bodies in, gets it to HL. Now Reggie Kirk will put it up to three. It's long. Rebound. Who's coming up with it? Haslam comes up with it to Nigel Lloyd. And a new 30-second shot clock, which is not moving at the moment. Don't ask me why. Finally begins to move. Reggie Kirk
Kirk works along the baseline, doesn't get there, rebound winless.
You know,
and the Derby Storm has the numbers. Doesn't get there, whistle on the play, let's see what we got. See what we got.
Well, the Richard Stokes, the referee, wants to have a word with both players, just calm them down.
Let's see which way is it going when we come back, because I'm not sure what happened, I have to say. They're going to bring Smith back in. It is a Derby ball, the decision.
Well, here comes Sean Smith, he's coming back in.
Yeah.
I think it's a good move for Jeff. He's got 2 minutes left in the quarter. He wants to see whether he can actually run on it.
Mike Finger again, speaking to Richard Stokes. Remember, Finger already had one technical foul in this game. Coaches are only allowed two. That's well. Smith doesn't get there. Who's got the ball? Pat Ronoy.
It's on a push-off, yeah. That's what you hear. There it is. Pushes Balser away.
That's the second foul on Fab Tornoy. Here comes the Storm again. That's with 2 minutes left to play in the third. Ben Berry. Double screen set for Balser. Gets it eventually. Now Windler. Great first move. Oh, tough play. Tony Windler.
Great move on the baseline. Two guys came across to check him, but Tony took it straight to them. Through the foul.
Well, goes in the line for two. I can tell you, my finger's been enough. Dorsey's coming back. This is a great move along the baseline. Tony Dorsey's back. There's Mike Finger jumping in the back. Would like to get it done here tonight. You know, the thing is, you go through a game three, and it's a one-game series.
It certainly is. But you know, Derby has got to put these free throws in. They're going to rue it if they don't. That could cost them.
Winless misses the first. And gets the spin. What a save! That's the way to save it.
Well, it was a great follow. He knew it was off straight away, and he followed it straight in, picked up the rebound, and popped it back in again.
You know what we've got? We've got us a 10-point ball game. Dorsey on the ball. Dorsey to Reggie Kirk. Derby Storm, foul is called on Atwell. Foul on Atwell with 1:24 left to play.
And both teams are in the penalty.
Yep.
So Reggie will go to the foul line and 6-2 here.
Worse than that, that is foul number 4 on Atwell.
Yeah, not good.
There's Reggie Kirk, nice move in the paint, but the foul situation is beginning to trouble Derby. Well, goes on to 4. Brendan Graves has 3. Deron Rutledge has 3. And Sean Smith is not 100%.
Absolutely. That's the problem.
Fails to make the first. Reggie Kirk. Is this about tension, seriously?
I think it must be, because you didn't see any of that on Saturday night. I mean, I sat there next to you Saturday night, and it was a clinic. It was an exhibition. From Birmingham.
23, 10 misses for Birmingham, 9 misses for Derby Storm.
Boy.
Ted Berry has the ball, 1:13 left to play in the third. Now Jeff looking to run a little delay game, looks like.
Yeah, it's a good move. He's going 4 low, the two wings are swinging through, then the post will cross over. There go the post now.
Winless puts it up, doesn't get there.
But Brendan Graves.
Out of court. Yes. Good call. Ted Berry suggesting he was pushed. That was a good call by the official.
Yeah, well, we'll see it here.
Brendan Graves goes up, gets a nice tip, runs around the rim, then runs off.
Right.
62-61. Nigel Lloyd working in the paint. Doesn't get the bucket. Will go to the line for one. Foul is on Balser. First.
You know, all those were dropping on Saturday night. This is the thing for Birmingham tonight. Everything they put up is bobbling around and coming out, but they are getting rebounds. They're keeping themselves in the game.
To be fair, you know, we got a lot of time in this
game. Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Brendan Gray still in the ballgame. Let's take a look at the breakdown of the rebound. 16 offensive boards for Birmingham. Can you believe
it? Yeah. Yeah, they're really going to the board strong. Birmingham have got 34 against Derby's 29.
But the other point, of course, is that, you know, you get offensive rebounds if you're missing shots.
That's very true.
Well, sometimes you get them anyway.
Well, you can only get them if you miss a shot.
Nigel Lloyd gets them both, has seven personal. 54-61. Well, it's working their way back into this one. Ken Berry. And again, running some delay game. Running some delay. 14 on the shot clock, there's about an 8 second differential. Ted Berry with the floater, doesn't get there, rebound Dorsey. And Dorsey breaks out with it. 15 seconds left in the third, Reggie Kirk. Oh, what a play by Reggie Kirk. The shot clock of Brendan Graves was there. Reggie took the decision not to go to the hole, lumped it up, and finished the play by Flournoy. Up for three, Balser.
It's good to know you can see Bobby's on the beach. Or take a quiet drive through the countryside. In a land where an Englishman's home is his castle, would he still find the odd cat dream? You can see a pearly queen, or two. It's good to know things haven't changed a bit.
Wake up to a clearer skin. Stop, forget about it. Just wash every day with new Clear So Complete. Helping stop spots has never felt so good. New Clear So Complete is all you need to help these spots.
Big night of boxing ahead this Saturday. Prince Nassim Hamed tops the bill, which includes Christy Back and Herbie Hyde, all going for a WBO world title. For further information on this special Sky box office event, call 0990 800 888. That's 0990 800 888 for a great night of world championship boxing. Here at the NEC, it's Birmingham against Derby. We're heading into the final quarter. Let's get back to Mike and Mike.
Take a look at some of the numbers on the first three quarters. Should be getting a little better now for Derby. Still just 1-for-6 on the three-point line. 961 points now on the two-point shot, but look at Birmingham dropping back.
Yeah, they are. To be fair, Derby were 0-for-5. They've only taken 1 three-pointer and scored it. But, you know, they're in it a lot more. They've taken a lot more shots now.
Okay, this is it, the start of the fourth quarter. 56-63. 7-point ball game. Brendan Gray gets a kick. Dorsey can throw this one down. Oh, baby! What a play! Tony Dorsey got hammered by the defender. Take another look at this. This is unbelievable. How's that for a foul? But the ball went into the basket. Look at this.
How on earth did he put that in the basket?
Wow. And one. I think this is a well-earned three-point play, don't you?
You know, Tully didn't score at all in that third quarter.
Spent a lot of time on the bench. And there's a turnover. Oh, Clive Allen's in trouble. Clive Allen is in trouble back in his own paint. Nigel Lloyd has the ball, puts it up. Doesn't get there. What a board by Fab Flournoy. Fab goes to work across the paint. Dorsey doesn't get there, rebound winless. Clive Allen is limping back up the court. Ball is with Windlass. Teddy, thought about the three. Windlass, thought about the three. And he just trying to get the go here.
No, I don't think that they're real comfortable with it. They want to be a lot patient.
Brendan Gray sees the post, gets it back. Needs help. Well, it's 4 seconds on the shot clock. There's Clive Allen. Coach is leaving him out there. We have some latest scores coming in, and take a look at this. Manchester fighting their way back into this one. 66 points to 70 at the end of the third. They trail by 4 at the 9X Arena. And we have some results. This is going to surprise you. Newcastle Eagles 73, London Towers 50. Towers allowed only 15 points in the second half. Be there for game 3 on Sunday. And the final one we have, Sheffield are gone from the championship. 75 to 97, Thames Valley back at Wembley for the first time in 5 years. Of course, Sheffield Sharks won the Uniball Trophy while Thames Valley won the National Cup. So Sheffield, Amici Robinson, Will Johnson and the rest, their season is over. Any surprise there, Coach?
No, I wasn't surprised. I expected Thames Valley to win. I think they're an excellent team and I think they've come strong. But I mean, Sheffield are a good team as well, but they squeaked it down there and I knew they'd go up there and really fight hard.
That is the first time the Sheffield Sharks have missed the final four since they came into the league 4 years ago. Windlass has the ball. 61-63. Bullets work their way into this one. They trail only by 2. 8-13. Kevin Kane, of course, who we said at the top of the show, has never missed. They say offensive foul.
I'd like to see that again, Mike.
Mike Burton,
I'd like to see that one again.
That's foul number 4 on Rutledge. Here it is.
Well, we haven't got a great angle there, Mike. It's difficult to see. Certainly Nigel went across. I did get position, but did he get it early enough?
Dossie along the baseline, doesn't get there. Clive Allen with the offensive board. Clive gets it into fast Flournoy. Now, Nigel Loy. Hang time, Nigel, count the point. We are tied at 63. Crowd making a lot of noise here.
Quarter of trail 7-0 following a nice 7-point lead on the third.
Yeah, well, the momentum swinging back towards Birmingham now. They're moving the ball well. Tight finding the open man.
Guys to go to another level here. Remember, to continue their season, they must win this ball game. bullet. Dorsey has the ball. Balser got around. Balser does a good defensive job. Dorsey has to go back to Fab Flournoy. Now Fab in the paint. The fadeaway doesn't get there. Big rebound by Graves. Foul is by Clive Allen.
You know, you would think it would be a mismatch with Fab Flournoy being marked by Atwell because of the size, but Fab gets up so high. Really jumps.
Then Rod Baker on the ball to Ted Berry. Where's Ted? That's my question.
Yeah, it's a good question. He hasn't really come to play in this game, has he?
Nope. Ted, nice spin. Now that's what he can do. Doesn't get there.
Yeah. But he's got to put the ball in the basket, hasn't he? He hasn't done that this game.
Dorsey with the pick and pick. Kicks it out, and Graves pulls in the ball. Then Roy Baker has it. Baker doesn't take it in there. Ball for the three. Doesn't get there. Who's got the ball? Ted Berry with the save, and what a save! And that'll be a blue ball.
Boy, we've gone to another level here.
Yeah, well, he's moved up. There's a lot of hustle going on. They're throwing themselves on the floor after the ball.
That's a great save by Ted Berry. Clive Allen to put it in. Nigel Lloyd has it. We still tied at 63. Kids have been on 63 for quite a while, so.
Yeah, since the last timeout.
Back to Nigel. Reggie Kirk pops out. Reggie has had a kind of a quiet game so far. They'll still have 15 points. It's short with that one. Rebound Fab. Nigel will put this up. No, he won't. Drives down the middle. Finger roll for two.
He's such a smart player, you know, Nigel Lloyd.
Well, you know they're going to come out and defend the three-pointer. Those are three mismatches. Brendan Graves. Oh, nice move. Brendan Graves ties it up.
That's a great reply from Derby. That was Birmingham's first lead for a long time in this game.
Dorsey has the ball. To Reggie Kirk and now Nigel Lloyd posting up. It's good! Who's going to win this one, though?
Well, it'd be a brave man to back Derby, I think. I'd like to see Derby win it, but I think the momentum's swinging away from him. I'd like to see Jerome Rutledge back on the floor. I'd like to see Sean Smith if he's fit back on the floor. But we'll have to see. There's five minutes to go.
Well, the bookies predicted it'd be a 12-point win for the Birmingham Bullets. That was obviously on the back of the last result. Atwell, nice move. Jump clock is at three. It's at two. Jump ball! Tough play by Clive Allen, although I think he wanted a charge.
I think he wanted a charge, yeah. He threw himself on the floor well. The referee thought it was a no call.
And they're both smiling, so that's okay. And it's noon 30 when we come back. The jump's going to be Clive Allen versus Atwell. Derby could do with this one.
Well, the two good jumpers there. Could go either way. Both Clive Allen and... Well, he gets it.
Well, gets it up there. Berry has it. Now they come back to the top through Ted Roy Baker, and they reset with a new shot clock. Ted Berry comes around the screens. Nice screen by Atwell. Berry works inside. He's tripped. And then they blow a whistle on it.
Yeah, well, Ted's looking for the foul. You just got in this situation, the refs aren't going to blow it. There's less than 5 minutes to go. The scores are real tight. You've got to take it strong. You can't be throwing your hands up in the air asking for a foul.
Billy Mims must have been wrong because there was a tomahawk there. When Dorsey misses the first. An interesting point here. Should this game go to overtime, and it's looking more and more like it, that could well be bad news to Derby because they've played, I think it's something like 8 or 9 periods of overtime this season.
I think it's more than that. I think it's 11. They've played 7 overtime games.
They haven't won one.
That's
yet.
Right.
It was a great block by Dawson.
One was triple overtime, one was quadruple overtime. But this, you're right, they're still to win one.
In the paint, Nigel Lloyd, down the point. No. Great save. And it's a 4-2.
Well, they're not moving it. They're not moving the ball well enough.
Wendler back to Baker for three. It's good.
quarter.
Yeah, well, he's a leader, and he knows what it's going to take.
Dorsey wide open.
As we said at the start of the game, Mike, he's a real contender for the MVP of the league.
When let's get you back to test. Oh, what a body move. Foul is on foul. Foul called on foul. There's what Dorsey's done us for quarter. We got nothing from him. He spent a lot of the third quarter on the bench. 11 points in the second, 6 so far in the fourth.
It's unusual for Tony to be on the bench. He usually goes 40 minutes.
Yeah.
He's got his foul trouble, is he?
Well, he has two. Maybe the first saw something he wasn't quite happy with. This is the tie the ball game. Doesn't tie it. Oh, what a hustle by Stanley Baker. Mentioned a second ago, Nigel Lloyd coming strong in this fourth quarter. Had a quiet game so far, but already has 6. And we've still got 3 minutes left to play.
Yeah, but it's not just his points, Mike. It's what he does with the basketball, finding the open man and getting the assist. And he plays tough defense as well.
It's a one-point ball game. Nigel Lloyd on the ball. He gets it to Reggie Kirk. Reggie lays it on the ground. Fades away. Doesn't get there. In and out. Rebound. Foul called on Clive Allen. Make that number 3. Clive does hustle, doesn't he?
Oh, he's a real hustler. But he wasn't too happy with the arm that got thrown then, I don't think. But David Atwell's a tough kid. See, David threw him away, you know.
Well, Atwell is one of the guys on 4 fouls. When he picks up another one, he'll be gone from this affair. Foul situation is definitely going to become a factor in these last 3 minutes. Senroy Baker tries to bank it home. Didn't get there. Lloyd has it. Lloyd with a little stutter step to hang time. Doesn't get there himself. And now Atwell breaks out for the ball. Gets it to Baker. Rutledge. Oh, what a pass. That is a white ball. That was a hot pass.
Yeah, I don't think
they're arguing about it. That came off fast.
I don't think Tony Windlass is ready for that. But I think it was a bit of a rush shot from Shedroy early on. I think they'd be better off really being patient and working the good shot.
Ball coming in from the end line. Shedroy Baker has it, brings it back to the top. Looks at the shot clock, please. There are 17 seconds left. 70-69, 2 minutes 19 left to play. Shedroy kicks it out, gets it back. Shot clock now at 10. Needs to go to the hole. Uses the screen. And gets the whistle. Let's see who it's on.
I think it's on Fab.
Yes, it is. Blocking foul on Fab, that's number 4 on Fab. 2 minutes, 11 seconds left to play in regulation. Shedroy Baker will go to the line for 2 shots. If he makes it, it's back, lead back to Derby. Nice drive by Shedroy.
Yeah, it was, and Fab took it in the chest, but he wasn't established.
Shedroy Baker misses his first one for the night, 2 for 3. If he makes this one, we will be tied at 70.
Well, that's what we've been saying all the way through, Mike. The free throws are going to count for Derby.
Fails to get there. Rebound pass, Flournoy. Again, Derby unable to get the lead. 48%, 11 for 23, 16 for 28. That's a 4-4-4.
Well, I mean, it's a one-point game. It's less than 2 minutes to go. It's going to be the foul line that's going to decide it.
Nigel Lloyd remonstrating with his other players. Balls are coming from the end line. 16 on the shot clock. 1:56 on the game clock. Reggie comes around the screen. Broken up, and he gave it back to Fab. Nigel right down the middle to fade away. Doesn't get there. Rebound, Atwell. Ted Roy Baker, 3-on-1. Ted Berry. Oh, what a flutter by Ted Berry.
Season, and in this game he hasn't really been able to get off. Takes it, drove to the basket.
Rises, floats around the defender. Only 4 for 12 tonight, that's kind of poor by Tim.
Yeah, that's not what we expect from Tim. Very poor.
NEC fans trying to get some noise going here. And there's the Derby fans trying to respond. Nigel Lloyd on the ball, they trail by one. Team and Dorsey before he even gets the ball. He couldn't do that in the NBA.
It'd be illegal defense.
Foul is called on Windlass.
Yeah, Tony's not very happy. Tony Windlass isn't very happy, and he's got a test, I think.
Nah, the referee thought about it, but he changed his mind.
Right.
Yeah, he just said to him, that was your warning. Tony Windlass going over now to talk to Jeff Jones. Jeff will just cool him down. I think what Jeff was saying there, you know, I do read a little bit. Jeff was saying, drive, take the foul and then put it up.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Dorsey gets one, we are tied at 71 apiece. Birmingham Bullets on the free throw line on the season, shooting round about 72%. Jack Berry has the ball. I wonder who these missed free throws is going to hurt the most. Jack Berry still on the ball. Now drives. Doesn't get there. Who's on the ball? White ball is the call. We have less than a minute left to play. Which way does this want to go? Who does it favor here?
Well, I think it's going to go to overtime. And if it goes to overtime, well, we know it doesn't favor Derby.
Okay. 59 seconds to get to me. Derby may have two offenses here. Ben Roy Baker has to push Keith Bruce out of the way. If Derby can get a score here, I think they'll be looking good to not lose this ball game.
That's a long way to go yet, Mike.
Well, that's
oh,
it around
here. And Dorsey didn't like it at all. But it wasn't a hard push.
And there's something else going on away from the officials. Fab Florence, I think, trying to quiet it down. Windlass getting a little close to Ryan Allen. You know, we've had a great ball game, but we don't need it. Now, let's see if we can get what happened here.
We've got a multiple foul here now. A foul on the player from each team. Six. A nine.
Going to be a jump ball now. That does not help the Bullets unless, of course, they win the jump.
Well, I think it will, because it's going to be between Tony Dorsey and Ted Berry. Now, I know Ted Berry can jump, but he's giving away a lot of height.
But if they get a score, unless it's a three, you know, Derby are probably going to get the ball back. There's a 1 second differential, 31 seconds. Let's go down. Let's talk about what's going on. And we'll bring in some stats. Second. Now I think this is the way it's going to go. The jump ball could go either way, but if Birmingham gets the jump, do you go for a two, do you take a three?
Well, he's got a choice. He either takes a quick two and pressing, or he goes for a three-pointer. I think he'll go for a three-pointer, because he's got a really good three-point shooting team. Of course, if Derby get it, they don't even want to take a shot till very, very late in the offense.
Well, the thing is, they don't have to. There's only be 1 second left. They can run out a 30-second offense. I remind you, 31.8 seconds, the exact time left on the clock, and Derby Storm lead this ball game by two. So Birmingham must score two to take it into overtime, or three to win. Here's the lead on the situation. As you can see, the early part belongs completely to the Birmingham Bullets. Then the Derby Storm worked their way on into it from the third quarter, and then it started going either way.
Well,
Birmingham has made 6 3-pointers in the ballgame, one in the second, of course, has 12 for 15 in game one on Saturday night.
Well, I don't think there was any pressure on them on Saturday night, but I think they're under a lot of pressure now. Derby has come to play.
H.L. Coleman now is back on the floor. I suppose my finger won't be at all bothered by overtime.
No, it won't bother
him. The difficulty that he's got, oh, they're trying to put H.L. Coleman on the line. H.L., move out.
No, as I said, it's between Tony Dorsey and Ted Berry. Now, Ted Berry can jump,
yeah.
So the interesting one, who's actually going to go? I think it's going to go to Fab off Tony Dorsey.
Oh, which way is it going? Who's got the ball? Going to be another jump ball. And this time, who is it going to be? It's going to be Ted Berry and Fab Flournoy this time.
But also,
these guys can jump.
Yeah, but also now, there's less than 30 seconds to go. So if Derby can get the ball, they don't have to take a shot. But Birmingham will foul them. And they'll put him on the foul line.
Fab is injured. Took a knock on through the head, looks like.
Yeah, well, he wants to sub off and bring a big guy on. You know?
He's not suggesting coaches do that. I'd never have believed it.
Well, you know, that's a great jumper, though. He'll get up there.
Yes. But you know, the decision still has to be made. Are they going for the two or are they going to go for the win? They need three to win the ball game.
No. They need a 2-4 overtime and they can win it from there. But if they're going to do that, they've got to take a real late shot. They can't give Derby a chance to take a shot after them.
The other factor is this, and it's one we haven't yet considered. Derby must not foul.
That's right.
You know, you foul Dorsey going to the hole, he gets the
two. Right, that's right.
On the line for one, it's all over.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure Jeff Jones has told him that.
So now, the jump is Fab Flournoy versus Ted Berry. Are we going to go for the full house and have a jump at the other end now? Off this one. We'll see. Reggie Kirk has the ball for the Bullet. Now, do they go for the three to win? Do they go? They go to Nigel Lloyd. Now, you cannot touch Nigel Lloyd. Nigel Lloyd leans in, gets the two. We are tied, but there are 12 seconds left to play. Then Lloyd Baker has the ball. Now, the shot clock is at 7. To see what Ted Berry had to put up with down low. I don't know if we've got it.
Jeff Jones is not very happy at all. Jeff Jones is not very happy at all. He thinks that Ted Berry was fouled. But he's got to be careful. He doesn't want to get a foul in.
He doesn't want to get a key.
No.
The key right now. Keith Bruce doesn't even want to talk to Jeff Jones. Turned and walked away. Let's see if we can pick this up again. There's Ted Berry.
Well, I can't see a foul, I have to say. I mean, Ted's jumping into it. I can't see a foul. Not from that angle, anyway.
Well, then it was a
this might be a better angle. This might be a better angle. No. Still can't see a foul. I think it was a good call, the no call.
Well, we're going to overtime. Last time on Sky, we had overtime, didn't we? My goodness. There's Jeff Jones trying to get his dive going. 73, let me remind you of the situation. Playoffs are the best of three. First game was played on Saturday at the Norway Center. And Birmingham Bullet annihilated. There is no other word for it. They annihilated the Derby Storm. Final score 111-79. There was a massive crowd up there. And I have to say, the vast majority went home devastated. Tonight, we're back here for game two. Birmingham, if they win this one, are through to the final four at Wembley. While if the Derby Storm can win, we'll be back here for game three on Sunday at 6:30. Is this going to change the score? Can Derby get their first overtime win?
Well, it'd be a good time to do it if they did, wouldn't it? But I'm surprised Derby didn't take it to the basket there. I don't want to force Birmingham to foul me, but that's over with now.
Dorsey has the ball. They say whoever scores the first point in overtime usually wins the ball game.
Who's
foul is called on HL, I think.
No, it's not.
They say right now. That's Ted Berry.
That's his third.
So Reggie Kirk will go to the line for two. Gets the first. Reggie Kirk 3-for-6 on the line, 47 now.
There's two big free throws, one.
Yeah. 16-point, they've got 17-point first throw. Ted Berry has got to step up here.
Berry looks to drive. Kicks it to Baker for three. Doesn't get there. Rebound. Rapid. Doesn't get there. Rebound. Nigel Lloyd. And Reggie Kirk. The finger roll does not get there. Ted Berry has the ball. Berry drives. Wraps it around to Baker. Now windless along the baseline. Doesn't take it. Gets it back. Now takes the two. And knocks down the two.
Yeah. That was a good offense. That was patient.
There it is again.
Right. Wide open. Got a good stand. I mean, he's got a good look there. There's nobody on him. And it's all tied up again, Mike.
Yeah. Only Derby are going to take us to four periods of overtime. Derby have had so many overtime games. They have played 11 periods of overtime. Not 11 games. Let me make that clear. They played 11 periods in the quadruple overtime, which is a joint record. Doesn't get their rebound. H.L. Coleman picks up the two. And they had a triple overtime. There's Nick Nurse looking on. Nick Nurse, the last coach to win a championship with this team. Oh, what a play! What a play, Ted Berry. How did he get there?
I don't know how he got there, but he did a heck of a job when he got there. He gets up quick, and he gets up strong, and he gets up high.
Only 5 for 15, 33%. 12 points tonight. Nigel Lloyd has the ball. We're tied at 77. Derby Storm, despite playing 11 periods of overtime, have yet to win a ball game which went to overtime. Tony Dorsey, surprisingly unable to handle the pass. That's very unlikely. 2 points are good for Tony Windlass. Now they have the lead by two. Less than 3 minutes left to play in this first period of overtime. Reggie Kirk. H.L. takes the three. It's good!
Well, you know, H.L. spent a lot of time on the bench in this game.
Yep. Boy, that is a big three. And a block by H.L. Reggie gets the two. That's a 5-point lead. Make that 3-point lead. Ted Berry has the ball. Berry, knocked away by somebody. And a foul is on Berry, that's number four.
Well, the last 2 times down the floor, Ted Berry turned it over. And now he fouls.
Timeout has been called. And now the group goes over. Listen to what Jeff Jones is going to say. Jeff Jones has called a timeout. Yes, this is it. 3-point ball game is where we're at the moment. With 2:15 left to play in overtime. When we come back, Bullets will have the ball. Are we at the free throw line?
Yes, that's it. Yes, we are. We're in the penalty, Mike. Yeah. Okay, it's going to be Nigel Lloyd going to the foul line at 2-2.
Right now on the offensive end, all right? Come down. Listen, everybody all right? Yes, that's our game, goddammit. Now listen. That means you got Flournoy. You got Coleman, you got Lloyd, you got Kirk, and you got Dorsey. What I want is 40, I want 41, but I also want some penetration off it. Ready, kick it. Hey, there's plenty of time. Let's come down, huh? Yeah, we can go to the hole. We got plenty of time. We'll go to the hole, we'll go to the line. Defensively, we're small. Everybody's got a rebound, all right? Let's go. Come on.
There's Jeff Jones. And I tell you what, we're going to go through all the results in the other games tonight. Manchester, I'm afraid, get the defeat. Greater London get the win at the Ninex. So they're one up in that series. Next game is Thursday night at the London Arena. Newcastle, 73. London Towers, 50. We're going to a game three in that one. Sunday, Newcastle Arena at 6:30. And finally, Sheffield 75, Thames Valley 97, Sheffield are gone. They've got a 4-point lead.
We got to see some full court pressure coming back from this.
Well, yeah, you have. But, I mean, Birmingham have stepped up in this course and they've put their big jobs in. That's what it's about.
Run as far as it'll go. Shot clock doesn't start until somebody on the floor touches the ball.
Well, it shouldn't have done, but it did.
Dorsey on the ball to Reggie Kirk. And Bullock just needs to run 30 seconds off this. And I have to say there's no better team at doing that. Nigel Lloyd working. He's going to back his man all the way down. Shot clock is down to 10. He's going to turn around, put it up. And doesn't get there. Rebound Windlass. They have the numbers this time. Ted Roy Baker will need to do it on his own. Oh, what a pass! Oh, what a play, Ted Roy Baker!
Great play, David Atwell. Great play, David Atwell, backing up and setting it strong. And now there's some pressure, but it's coming in full court. The two guys in the backcourt both backed off.
It's a three-point game. HL won't take that as a three. Nigel Lloyd has it. They need a score here. They need a score.
And you've got a bad matchup there, because Nigel can just back him down and get a shot like he did before.
Shot clock is at 7, game clock is 57, double team comes. Nigel Lloyd gets it off short. Who's got the ball? That's the white ball. So the situation is 3 points at tie, but there are 51 seconds, which means Birmingham will get the ball back. At least one.
Yep.
What? My finger saying no three. Now is that for his guys or
no, he doesn't want to let
him in up to three.
He doesn't want to let Derby take one. But if Derby took a quick shot, they'd get another shot.
Absolutely. Two for one.
There it is.
Balser. And it's good. And they get the ball back with 9 seconds.
Now the key now is not to foul.
They don't want to foul.
Derby must not foul. They don't want to give the ball back to Birmingham.
If they foul, you know, this is where coaches earn their money. If they foul with about 15 seconds, put the man on the line, they have 15 seconds going in the opposite direction. Could we be heading here for another overtime? There is a 4-second differential. Dorsey has the ball. Dorsey takes a three. It's way up. And Benroy has the ball. 3 seconds. 2 seconds. 1 second. Derby win the ball game. Derby win the ball game. What's we're going to game three. Derby Storm win the ball game. Let's go down. The referees are gone from this one. They're going to the locker room. They are gone to the locker room. This one is over. Ted Roy Baker is over with his crowd. The Derby fans are making a lot of noise. Birmingham Bullets thought they could end it here tonight. They could not do it. This has been a big game for the Derby Storm. They finally win an overtime game. So
they've got the monkey off the back. And they've been trying to do that all season. And I have to say, I'm really pleased with Jeff Jones. He's come in late, halfway through the season.
Well, there it is. What a fantastic ball game. That is it. 84 to Birmingham Bullets, 86 to the Derby Storm. Bryan Balser celebrating. Let's go down top to Jeff Jones and Tony Windlass. There with Suzanne Dando.
Thanks very much, Mike. Jeff Jones. I mean, if you can hear me, your crowd at the end is going mad. That is 12 overtimes, and that was the important one.
It's about the most important one I think they've played all year. I personally thought we should have been going to the line and into regulation, so maybe that's a little bit of justice, but I got to give them credit. Every time they're back to the wall and it's on the line, they definitely come through. They did a great job.
We heard what Coach said there, Tony. Every time you're backed against the wall, it was a pretty tough game for you in the first leg, but you bounced back in the second.
Well, that's true. The coach was explaining this. Guard Dorsey, you know, that was my job all night. I didn't care about scoring. I just want to stop Dorsey. And I think we all did a good job on Dorsey. So the key is stop Dorsey. That's it.
You obviously did. I mean, their shooting percentages went down. You went up defensively. But that last basket, Jeff.
I just kind of closed my eyes. When they missed, I thought, here we go. And unfortunately for us, this one went in. So obviously, I'm ecstatic to be back Sunday, and hopefully we got another one where it's the last 40 minutes and we don't win, and hopefully we won't let everybody down.
We're back to the drawing board, a bit more coaching, and the third leg back here. Tony, how do you feel about that one? An important one for you, obviously.
Well, the most important thing is just keep playing hard, no matter what happened. I mean, this game right here is a bonus for us, and just come back and play the same way, just play even harder and smarter. That's it.
Well, it was a smart game tonight. Congratulations to you both, and good luck in the third leg.
Thanks very much.
Come on, guys, it's going to a third leg, Mike, but you had a feeling, didn't you, that Derby might get this one?
Well, I think Derby was a tough team, and I think they played tough tonight. They certainly didn't last Saturday, and I think they've done themselves proud tonight. They came to play, and they played hard.
Who do you fancy now for the final one?
I think Birmingham have got the most talent. And I think it could hinge a lot on that Sean Smith's injury to his ankle, but I think Birmingham will fancy the chances, but I'm sure it'll be a close one.
Okay, thanks very much for being with us tonight, Mike. Just a reminder that Thames Valley at the moment are the only side through to the Championship weekend. We will be showing you one of these third leg games this Sunday. That'll be, as usual, at 6:30, but it's going to be on Sky Sports 3, so look out for that one. We're either going to be here at the NEC, we'll be at Newcastle, or we'll be at the London Arena for one of those third leg ties. It's going to be a cracker, whatever it is. Well, hopefully it'll be as good as we've had tonight. A great night for Derby Storm. They have finally overcome that overtime jinx. Well done to them. Unlucky for Birmingham, but we'll see you again on Sunday. Join us then if you can. Bye-bye for now.
On Sky, more all-round entertainment. On Sky One, a brand new series of Poltergeist. And look out for a tour of a hot summer down under. May 16th is your day with Miss Universe.
Scream with Sky Box Office. Tim Allen's gone tropical.
What am I supposed to do now?
In Jungle to Jungle. Tommy, Uma and George, Batman and Robin.
On Sky Sports, the excitement includes the Scottish Cup Final. International football and live for the first time on Sky, the FA Cup Final. There's lucky seconds to the Cup Final and cricket the Texaco Trophy.
Sky Movies.
When does it end?
Never. Keanu Reeves. Chain Reaction. Liam Neeson.
Oh, yes, please.
An all-star cast, Michael Collins.
Surprise, surprise.
Robert De Niro, Wesley Snipes, the fan.
The captain working for the United States government.
Gina Davis, the long kiss goodnight. All-round family fun. May on Sky.
I do this, it's all in.
When I tell people I'm part of the World Land Speed Crew, they get pretty excited. They ask, like, are you the driver? Are you the designer? Are you the owner? Nope, I'm the safety guy. I pick up the parachute after the run. They look at him disappointed and go, oh, that's pretty, great. And I say, nope, not the drive home, is.
Left, two up again. You're in the right direction, but it's the third furlong. Not five. No. Left, no, left. No, further up. Up. No, Jack. Yes. No, not that up. Down. Down.
At least using oil is easy. Duckham is premium engine oil.
Right then. Come on, boys. Come on. Come on.
William?
Will you feed him for me?
Oh, you don't need... William!
Carl has captured delicious chunks and vitamin rich jelly. Did you feed him?
Come on, William. I'll do it.
Hard, because it's hard work being a family dog.
Oh, hello. Is that a gnome? Yeah, I'm just going to run him over with his little fishing rod. Something like that. Anyway, it'll be a tenner, please. Not very nice, is it? Charging people for bad news. That's why, if you need to arrange an overdraft, then having an actual bank account doesn't add to it, they're charging a fee. All for a lesser tone about it. Did you have a greenhouse?
Have you now? Is life complicated enough?
This is Sky Sports 1.
The Sport of Hope, Todd will give the lifeline to players on the fringe.
We're in the driving seat now. The Gunners have met their favourites for the title.
Parker grabs a point for Leicester with a 90th minute penalty.
In the
the Sports Centre, Gabby Lawrence and Julian Waters.
Hello, with the World Cup final just 7 weeks away, the battle for places in France is hotting up. Full details of England and Scotland's latest squads coming right up.
And as Arsenal are installed as favourites for the Premiership title, we hear from the bookie who's already paid out on Manchester United's win.
The table.
They're not here, then they get the time in their place.